Hi, friends.
Hello.
Hello, and welcome to the non-Greg Stoles, Greg Stoles show, except only substitutes. I am your host, the Pamazon. Yes. I am the Pamazon. We have, there
respect.
We go.
Yo, respect. What be up? I is here with none other than my main host and my main frequent guest. May.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Oh yeah, we got this thing.
You just saw the eyeballs.
He's a kissing void boy. Eyeballs. It's hard to see him.
Yes. Void cat.
It was between Aku, because he has the pointy little teeth like the main bad guy in Samurai Jack, or Dusty, which is a cat made of stars in a really cool video game series.
Oh.
Which video game series is that?
Gravity Rush for the PSP Vita.
A PSP classic.
Vita. That's what it is, yes.
Do either of you guys like Kung Fury? I really like that movie.
I've never seen it.
I don't think I've seen it. Is that the one with the giant panda?
No, it's about a...
confused.
It's like about time-traveling cops with dinosaurs that go back and fight.
Oh my god, Kung Fury? Yes, I love that.
Yeah.
It is fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, isn't that great?
Yeah, it's so ridiculous.
Yeah,
and it's got a lot of bad CG in it.
It's good. Like, yeah, it's. I was just thinking about it. I love Kung Fury.
It's got a fight between... Kung Fu fighters and what, like Nazi dinosaurs?
Yeah, like all sorts of Nazi dinosaur stuff. It's only 31 minutes long. You don't get much to lose.
Yeah, they're going to make a second half, I think.
Yeah, I've heard that. I was just thinking a lot about that today.
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous.
Yeah, it's a great movie.
And it's got a lot of filters of light to it, so it looks like it's on a, like, old VHS.
Yeah, oh my god.
That's kind of fun.
Is Dudley watching Kung Fury? Is that what I'm hearing?
I don't know if Dudley is.
I am watching LTV.
That's a TV show.
Oh.
I love that show.
I don't know what that is either.
That's Weird Al's TV show.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Other than the Weird Al show, which is not as good as LTV.
I kind of like the Weird Al show.
I like the Weird Al show too, but I just like the interview parts of LTV.
I've never seen it, but I have seen Police Surgeon.
Now, Police Surgeon, that's a real show. That's a show!
Ridiculous, oh my goodness.
Yeah, I like
it. It's about, like, the idea that there's a police surgeon who goes around to crime scenes.
But he doesn't really do anything.
I don't know what he thinks he's gonna do.
Like, I've never seen him really do much anything.
Hold on. I can save them. I just have to take the serial killer's abandoned body parts and stitch it back together into one person.
I mean, has he ever really saved anybody? I mean,
I don't know. I'm sure he must have.
Yeah, I don't know.
I got really excited when I turned on the TV with one of those stations and there was, like, Murder, She Wrote on it. I was like, oh, I used to watch this with Grandpa all the time. And then I, like, started watching. I'm like, ooh, this isn't aged well at all.
No, it's very bad.
Very,
yes.
Very bad.
Yeah,
why?
Very bad.
I've never watched it.
My mom used to watch Murder, She Wrote. She loved Murder, She Wrote.
So bad.
It's very bad procedural sort of thing where it's always, like, crazily somebody who committed the murder and she knows somehow through some clues. It's not really a clue and just impossible to really know.
It's kind of like Agatha Christie, but... bad.
But bad, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mr. Rogers, that was the only show I think he ever was in other than his own, at least as an actor.
Who?
In Murder, She Wrote, I believe. I saw something where it was one of the only shows where he was in playing something other than himself.
Who?
Mr. Rogers.
Oh, Mr. Rogers.
Who is my favorite person ever?
Do-do-do-do-do.
I love Mr. Rogers so much. It's my aim in life to just kind of be Mr. Rogers. He's so cool.
Sorry, I had to change a couple notes for copyright reasons.
Yeah, let's think of that. Right, we didn't.
Hey there, neighbor.
I put the most, what I thought was an obscure song on my video and uploaded to Facebook, and immediately, like, you're stealing this song.
Content!
Like, we're not even making money. We're just, Jesus.
Copyright law is out of control.
Thank you, Disney, in the 1980s.
Yeah.
Oh, we can't have Mickey go public domain. That's our bread and butter. That and making young girls think that they need to either change awful men or be princesses.
Yeah. Oh, the whole princess thing kills me.
Ugh. Or change their entire selves and not be a fish person so that they can walk among the people.
I seen you, and it was once upon a dream. In forest, also ever lady light.
I don't know what's happening.
Yeah,
right,
I don't
now.
Know what that is. What is it?
You don't know the song from Sleeping Beauty?
No, I do know that, but I don't know the lyrics to it because I only know the tune.
I don't know
because
if I ever saw Sleeping
I know
Beauty.
The tune from the episode of Ren and Stimpy where it's the cosmonauts versus the astronauts, and it's
one.
The pigs, and when his helm, Stimpy's helmet gets shattered, that plays. It's like...
It's Tchaikovsky, or however you say it. Come on, it's a classic of 19th century music.
And then he accidentally plugs it into the septic tank rather than the fuel tank.
Yes, I don't know. I personally like the Sleeping Beauty waltz song. I think it's lovely.
Just had something under your eye, that's all. I'm not trying to hurt you.
I personally think I'd look lovely in a princess dress, but...
You do make a nice princess.
Oh, gosh. Oh, thank you. I want to be the wonderful princess of love and beauty.
Hey, buddy. Whatever stuck under your eye.
I don't know.
I think I got it.
I have a shoulder beast.
You do. It's a fetching shoulder beast.
Comic recommendation, at least. Sometimes it's comic, but I should do someone that's not. I just bought this yesterday, I suppose, but
there you go.
Speak into the microphone.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I forgot about this. It's just basically, I bought this from Gutter Pop Comics.
Gutter Pop is a wonderful,
it's wonderful
shop
strange,
down on Elmwood that's got lots of weird things.
Little, just like doodles Robert Crumb does. But it's funny because like the whole thing, he's just like, you know, I used to just make these terrible drawings and just kind of leave them at restaurants, but people will pay me thousands of dollars for this, and I think it's really funny that people will buy these. So.
Well, I used to do that all the time. Why am I not rich?
Because I'm weird.
It's random. All that stuff is random. So random. Also, yeah.
I'm probably not a creep enough.
He's like the only one out of like the 60s comics that ever really like went anywhere past that scene, it seems like. Spain is from Buffalo, though. Spain was like one of his best friends and also one of the people who did all the Zap comics.
Speaking of people who are from Buffalo, you know those videos on YouTube that are like the cracked videos that are like if so-and-so was honest, like toothpaste commercials were honest. There's got the guy who's like, hi, I'm Roger. He's from Buffalo. Jack Hunter. He was like a actor and like theater professor here for like 20 years and a cab driver and a couple other things.
He clearly wrote his own
IMDb entry because it's very tongue-in-cheek and it has lines in it like, and his daughter said, Dad, I'm 19. I don't need you anymore. You can go to California if you want. Things like that.
You should look up the IMDb for Captain Isotope. And I'm just saying we should have an IMDb. I mean, we're on TV all the time. I mean, you know, why don't we have one? I've been to music and stuff.
What is that international mastication dark boogers?
I have all those. I've done all those.
Oh, okay.
Especially this last...
I had the flu. I used to do roofing, and that was a lot of dark.
Oh, yeah. The flu was very bad. I couldn't breathe.
I'm lost.
We lost John.
Brown sweat.
We lost John.
Anyways.
Brown sweat. I've never done that. I don't know what.
Well, you weren't living here when she had that really awful flu that one.
That was bad. That was
but so.
Yeah, my roommate came out and said, please go to the doctor because I think you're going to die. That's always a danger when someone says
Well,
that,
we were sick. It didn't hit us for a while and we didn't feel well. And then it hit us and we don't remember an entire week.
Yeah.
And then we were still sick for like another month.
That was a bad
thing.
Yeah,
it was awful.
That was very bad. That was a bad, bad, bad one.
Actually, we got rid of our old futon mattress because of that flu.
Oh, really? Oh, dear. I'm going to knock on this wooden chair and say this last flu was not anything. I mean, I missed a day of work, but yeah. Mainly because I could not sleep, and it was like 5 a.m., and I was, if I laid down, I couldn't breathe. So I was like, I cannot go get up at 8 and go teach people. I 3 hours of sleep and a head full of snot, and yeah, that would be ugly. I just won't even be able to think straight, so.
So, John, I believe you had the floor while we rudely interrupted your Arkrom telling?
Oh, no, it's just, you know, it's just kind of just random drawings of stuff and some by his daughter and him did together while they're just, you know, sitting there eating restaurants. And it's just funny stuff where he's like, damn, he's like, this has, like, food stains on it. People pay more.
One. Which one? That one.
Oh, I like that one. He's like, you know, people pay more when there's food stains on it. The art collectors say that means it's more valuable. I don't get it, but you people are buying it. Hmm. I like how he knows that it's, like, really strange and stupid, but he's like, whatever, I'll take your money, I don't care.
There's actual bits of DNA and snot from
I like the aliens on the cover. I think they're pretty funny aliens. It's kind of like the thing going around now where aliens don't understand stuff. But like,
the jumping camera.
This is one of his, not newer books, but it's from the 2000s. You know.
Dudley, what are you doing with the camera?
But I don't know. I like Robert's drawings.
Yeah, that's the roughest when they start shifting around, digging in. You're like, oh, don't do that. Don't do it.
And then you're like,
oh,
claws! Come on, climb back up.
Climb back up.
Yep, there
you
go.
He's moving his butt back up.
Yeah, that was a good boy.
I like the movie, the Arkham movie. I show it to my students, and it's always fun times.
I love that movie.
They get upset.
Oh my god!
They do. Lots
I know he didn't like Fritz the Cat, but I'd like to see your students' reaction to that movie. Especially the scene that happens in the bus.
Oh, Jesus.
I never remembers. Yeah. John knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I'm sure I know, but I'm still under the weather.
I can't imagine just drawing that many, like, cat genitalia and, like, animal genitalia. It's like, you know,
you have clearly never seen anybody's account on Fur Affinity or known furries who have accounts on there. Oh my god.
That's all they draw.
I've been to furry parties. I've had them ask me to draw it, but I wasn't going to draw them what they wanted to draw because. Because
you're a free man.
Oh well.
You draw what you want.
I just.
No, a free bird. You draw what you want.
But furry parties are very unpleasant experiences. Everyone's very sweaty. Everyone's. What is? Bird.
Bird?
I got no problem
with
furries.
Does that mean Andrew fine. Bird should just be called Andrew Dick?
Andrew Genitalia.
Why?
Andrew Genitalia?
Because he overdoes the freaking whistling and all that cheery
it's
whistling.
It's just because you're
cheery
a sad,
whistling.
Cynical monster.
Cheery whistling all over.
I mean, furries, they get so much...
You know what? It's
like
because you already chose a sensitive white boy to listen to, and it's Sufjan Stevens.
He's better. He's the superior sensitive white boy that is also a cancer. They're like born very close to each other, which is kind of weird. Their birthdays are like days apart.
Yeah, well, I used to pet sit for a musician who once played with Andrew Bird.
Oh, yeah?
So, I mean, her parents, not her directly.
Oh, okay.
But that's my lame claim to fame. Also, they have her paintings all over the house, and I think it's good she went into music.
That's good that she made the correct choice.
Yes.
Okay, do you know who Andrew Bird is?
No, I don't know who
that
is.
That's okay. You know who Sufjan Stevens is, though?
Yeah, I know Sufjan.
They're kind of like... Sufjan Stevens is more, like, sad and, like,
yes,
lyrically...
Sad.
Sufjan Stevens is more like sad lyrically, and Andrew Bird sounds upbeat, but if you listen to the lyrics, they're all upsetting or about murder or things.
Yeah, that's kind of true. So. I just think Sufjan's just so musically ambitious that I also like that a lot.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Not that Andrew Bird is unambitious, but Sufjan's just kind of over the top.
Yeah.
He's so extra.
See, I find it easier to listen to the lyrics that are about, like, creepy things as opposed to just sad things.
Yeah.
So I like Tom Waits too. Also,
we sailed the night for Singapore. Well, all is mad as hatters here.
How can you hate Tom Waits? He sounds like he gargles with gravel.
He does. He does sound that way. That's true.
Also, every time he shows up in a movie, you probably know the movie is at least worth watching part of.
To see him?
Yeah.
Do you know who Tom Waits is?
Oh, yes. Okay. Because Primus is probably my favorite band. And of course, he voices Tommy the Cat. And he's also in, he produced some time of Primus songs.
What was the, was it Sean Lennon album?
Oh, I love that. Sean Lennon and Les Claypool. I love that. The Claypool Lennon. That's one of my favorite. I like that even more than
Primus. That seems like such a weird combo. But it's good.
There was this Disney Songs cover compilation album, and I don't know why he decided to do one. I think because he just thought it would be funny and creepy. And he covered Hi Ho.
Who did?
Tom Waits.
Oh, okay.
And my dad used to play it to freak my sister out because she's doesn't like Tom Waits. She's like, he's creepy.
Hi-ho.
I can see where that would be creepy, though. Sounding, you know, it could easily make that song ominous sounding, you know.
Every time I see an abandoned building that has a building that looks abandoned that has a light on it and I can see inside or anything and like it's peeling wallpaper and stuff, I'm like, that looks like where Tom Waits would live.
that reminds me, you want to hear my Tom Waits inspired song, which it wasn't really, but it sounds a lot like it. Listen to the Benunu Kazoo doing The Ballad of Stevie Armstrong. It's a very funny song I wrote about a guy who loses his arms over time and they're replaced with Gatling guns.
That sounds fantastic. Have you ever seen the movie Machine Girl?
No.
It is a Japanese grindhouse movie, kind of inspired partially by other grindhouse movies from the US and also a little bit from Evil Dead, and it's pretty fantastic.
I know what it is. Like a picture of the cover. I've seen it.
There's a part in it that's like a scene-for-scene replica of the scene in Army of Darkness where Ash like raises his fist up and like catches the chainsaw on a stump, but it's with the girl and it's a machine gun. Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's pretty fantastic.
Where would they find this? Where would our gentle viewers find this song?
They're not that gentle. You know they're doing something crazy.
Gentle viewers.
No calls that are just grunting or heavy breathing, please.
John, how do they find this song?
Find what? Oh, me. I forgot I was on this. Just look up Captain Kirk Records and search the Benunu Kazoo. There's only one song. We've recorded more songs, but somebody won't let me release them. So, you know. But there's other songs, but that's the only song that came out. It's a wonderful little mini CD single, but you can get it for free. So, get it for free.
Free is good.
So, I think it's kind of funny that you two are so, like, offended by puns sometimes. Like, it's like pouring holy water on a demon or something. Tell a bad punny joke. Because Captain Crook Records is clearly a play on Captain Hook.
It was named after a cat. And also, Captain Crook is a McDonald's character. But I think that's originally where it came from. Captain Crook was this cat that Slade had that only had two legs. And didn't walk very well.
I would think not.
One in front, one in back?
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
I don't know how it even walked at all.
It didn't walk for very long.
See, I saw a Whippet online that had one front leg and one back leg, and it wasn't very stable when it was standing still, but man, did it run fast.
But that's why the symbol of Captain Kirk Records is a cat.
I see. Very cool. I like that.
Yes. Captain Kirk Records celebrating its 12-year anniversary next year.
We have one of your stickers on our coffee table.
Ah, delightful.
So delightful.
I found it because the wonderful Miss Gabby Lang, who is also she's in the Primus sphere. She plays a lot with Les Claypool and with the Lennons and all that. But she was on Captain Kirk Records, and she's like, oh my god, I know this guy named Slade, I think he'd love him. And she sends me his email, and I think, oh fuck, I have all this weird stuff. I love him. And I'm like, oh, thanks, Slade. And next thing I know, I talk to him every day for the next, like, you know, 10 years.
Fine romance, da 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 da.
I don't have words.
That's all right, it could be a fine romance.
Okay.
So have you been working on any of your comics?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, not as much. I've been having issues, but I've been, you know, when I can here and there. But I ran Captain Kirk Crickets for like a year when Slade totally lost his mind because his girlfriend left him. And he moved to Arizona. So I had to run Captain Kirk Records for a while.
Bad breakups and mental health issues. They don't go together well. Regardless of whether or not they're the kind of mental health issues you're totally aware of.
Yeah, they'll bad breakups. No good.
Yeah, he moved to Arizona and ran it for a year?
Yeah, he did. And he was just like totally nuts for a while. And then he met Whitney, who was so just like changed him. And
Whitney?
Whitney, where's my kids' mail? God! Where's the toy, Whitney? Immediately for... Hey, John, where's the nearest Toys R Us? And I'm like, all right.
They don't exist anymore.
No
more.
Which is actually kind of sad because they had really cool Lego kits.
Oh.
I like Legos.
I hadn't been to one in a long time. But
yeah, me neither.
I was because I was late, but,
So, I've been working on art of my own recently.
Did you sign up for infringement?
No, I didn't because I figured out I wouldn't have time for it.
Oh.
For all the stupid stupid markets so that we could make money, stash it away and survive the winter.
You still sign up in film? Film? Literature art?
Just slowly making digital paintings on a DS with a video out to a PVM count as film?
It could, I guess. I don't know. I don't know where it would count yet.
Stay hydrated, H2 hose.
We just find a spot, you know, generally for people. Somebody wanted to burn a piano while playing it, and it took us a while.
Oh, yeah,
but we found a spot.
That was actually really cool.
It was during Music is Art. We couldn't do it during the actual infringement, but we were able to do it and help them out. So.
It was pretty fantastic, and I was amazed at how long that piano remained playable.
Yeah, right.
I was like, that should not be playing anymore.
Right.
We're making any notes, and it still is just like, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
And it stayed in tune pretty long, too, which was even more amazing.
I know. I was, like, terrified about the... I guess the strings can break and then come through and whack and it's...
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I don't get it. Why not just keep the piano?
Because during the 20th century, there was a boom... Early 20th century and late 19th century. In mid-19th century, I think, there was a boom in pianos as a recreational thing in the home. So there's a shitload of them.
Well, I think that one also, the tuning pegs were to the point where you couldn't really, it wouldn't stay in tune very long. So it was pretty much toast.
Yeah. And there's certain things where it's like, yes, this is a fixable thing, but the people are going to charge you more to fix it than just to buy a new one because they want you to buy a new one. So that might be a thing. Same kind of thing with pianos. I don't know.
I don't know either because I don't own any pianos. So
my parents did for a while. I learned to play Chopsticks and Mary Had a Little Lamb and the very beginning of the Titanic song.
Okay.
On repeat, which drove my parents crazy.
I had a little kid's organ, and the theme from The Godfather was in the book, and I played that all the time.
Not ominous at all.
Yeah, this little kid in the hallway, like, madly playing the theme from The Godfather over and over.
Did you have a mask that covered half your face? Because you're pale enough, instead of being a white mask, it was
dark
mask.
Yeah, right. I had no mask, no, but I played that little organ so much. I love that organ.
That's so fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I've been doing paintings and doodles recently. I was doing sketches of this guy because he's obnoxious. I'm thinking about doing a webcomic, but I haven't done it yet. But I have a painting to show, if that's okay.
Yeah, sure.
You've brought it with you?
Yeah.
It's
on the
pooter. I mean, it's a digital painting, pooter. So...
It's on the pooter.
Yes.
Show us.
I shall once it's awake because it fell asleep. So just keep talking about things till I get it running.
Probably by the time you see this, I mean, those categories may be closed too for infringement. But if you've got them, you know, it doesn't hurt to look. We need more film. We need more workshops. We need more literature spoken word. We need more. We're not bad with the art, but we said we'd take some more. theater and music are closed because we got a lot of that. So, yeah. Lots of theater and...
Theater and music, you got a lot of that.
And we did.
For infringement in Buffalo?
Yeah, we did. There's lots of musicians. Buffalo's
And a lot
musicians.
Of drama.
No, yeah, apparently. Apparently lots of drama. There's a lot of filmmakers, but I don't...
I got
they
it.
Just, I don't know. It's hard to get them to...
So...
submit.
I was messing around. It's like, I'm really inconsistent with my art. It's awful. I was messing around with a drawing program that's a piece of homebrew on the original DS, because I was playing around with that because I'm a tech geek and stuff, and I keep old things all the time. And I accidentally closed it. Give me a second. Oh, jeez. And so I was seeing if this drawing program could actually do decent paintings or anything, and it's pretty good for drawing. So I,
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to pull your hair. I was trying to pull your hood out.
Come on, open up. There we go.
I'm sorry. I'm over here pulling John's hair.
Wait, nope, that's the wrong one. Nope, that's the right one. There we go.
Oh, it's so amazing.
Now it's true.
It's even got ghost house noses.
Oh, there you go. Very, very nice. Awesome. You should.
Yeah. If anybody has an old DS and a flash cart, it's colors 1.1, and it draws at a very low resolution, but it like saves all the brush strokes you did. It's like you can rewind it to any point, and it saves all the brush strokes. And when you go to export it at a bigger size, it just repaints it at that higher resolution.
Oh, that's
it's
a great
really
idea.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
And it is now on Android and iOS, and I think the 3DS 2. It's not the best painting program for all of those, but it's kind of there's this weird kind of it's kind of like, you know, like doing pixel art on a black and white Macintosh. There's something a certain aesthetic about the old. I like doing art on things that weren't meant to do art or.
Yeah,
had
no,
weird
that's
limitations.
Fun. I like playing music on, you know, the weirder and goofier the better. You know?
Oh yeah, like there's a Korg, official Korg synthesizer for the DS2, which I think you feel like I'm gonna wait for you to forget that, and it's gonna be a Christmas present. Anyways.
I never even gave my sisters the Christmas presents yet.
I know, they're still in the back room.
Also, it's very funny. There's this Arab corner store near where I work, and they still have the remains of jack-o'-lanterns left sitting on their back stair.
It's got to be kind of
It's
smushy.
Very gross. It's literally just a pile of smush. Like, there's nothing. It's, like, almost flat. It's very funny. There's also always mysterious trays of food back there.
Look at this cat. Maybe he's really getting
critters.
Into it, isn't he?
He's taking
like
a look around.
Frozen. It's like... I don't know. That's just a very funny place. There's always
that's kind of funny. You know those pumpkins, those gourds that look like Metroids. They're like pumpkin shape on the top, and they have the three legs on the bottom.
Yes.
We got them literally just because they look like Metroids. We still have one from Halloween, the year we moved here.
Oh wow!
And it's solid. It's not squishy at all. It's like, dunk, dunk, dunk. Sounds like a ripe watermelon. It's really weird. I'm afraid if we drop it, it's going to explode and be full of spiders or something, but it's really cool that it's still solid.
Spider squash.
Spider squash. Scary stories to tell in the dark. The girl with the spider leg.
Oh, no.
By the way, if anybody remembers the Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark series from the 1980s and early 90s, which had fantastic art, and when they redid them, for the re-release, they changed the art, which just kind of ruins it. So collect them now before they become expensive. like all the things I want. Matrix switchers and PVMs. Oh my god, they're so expensive. Anyways, if you don't know, there's a movie, or is it a TV series, coming out, directed by... What's his face? Who did...
I don't know what.
Pan's Labyrinth. Guillermo,
Guillermo
del Toro,
Guillermo.
And it looks hopeful? I mean, it looks like it could be really good or terrible, but usually his stuff's pretty
good. Drink your spaghetti sauce, children.